I'm Nicole, I'm 34, and I have 22 deletion syndrome. I also have my own page on Facebook called Mother and Son with 22Q deletion. I created a page because basically at the time being, I just wanted to meet new people who are like me, because at that time, I was having a hard time making friends and was down all the time. But I created this page that I have on Facebook 2014. I grew so much. I grew up a lot. When I was a kid, I got bullied a lot because of my speech. And it was tough. I went through a lot of speech therapy. I had surgery for my speech. They said when I got my adenoids and tonsils taken out, that helped a lot with my speech. Because I used to have to, like, point to, like, food or cups or drinks or anything for if I wanted something when I was younger. My parents had, you know, they got it for me because I had a point and they couldn't understand me. I talk so much better now. I still do have my moments, because say if I talk really fast, you would not be able to understand me. If I get all excited, and then I start talking really fast too, a lot of you wouldn't be able to understand me. If you're around me enough, you will learn to understand me, but if, like, when we're together a day and you don't really know me, you probably won't understand me. And you might be able to if I slow down my words, and you'll be able to probably understand me. I went through a lot of speech therapy ever since I was a little kid all the way up to probably middle school. I was in also special education classes all my life. I tried college. It was very difficult. It was very hard to put it in place. First time was computers. Second time was medical assistant. Now, that medical assistant, I was very proud of myself, though, because I did pass a couple classes. So, that's a good proud thing that I can say that I did do. It was just too hard. The testing was difficult. I did get help. I was able to go to a different room. It was nice and quiet. Yeah, I didn't have no, like, looking around, but, oh no, I'm the last one. None. That's how I am. I have speech, and I have a disability. My reading is pretty good, except I can read it to myself, but explaining it to you, it's hard. It's hard, like, reading comprehension, it's hard for me. But I can read pretty good, though. Math is another one of my weakest subjects ever. I'm 34 years old, and I still have the hardest time counting money back. And I hate saying it. It's so embarrassing because I'm 34. And it's hard for me to count money back. I count my fingers. I get really nervous and I just can't do it. Math was really, really difficult for me. And it still is. I have had 3 jobs in my life. I've worked at Culver's, McDonald's, and now I'm at a hotel. As a housekeeper, it was not bad, but no, for over 4 years. When I first started out having a job, like, at Culver's, I got help. I went to the vocational rehabilitation, like, help haven. They helped me with my interviews, writing out resumes and everything. My very first job, I had a shadow. My very first day, I had, like, somebody coming with me and helping me that I needed help with. And after that, I didn't need the help no more. After I quit Culver's and went to McDonald's, I did McDonald's all on my own. I did the hotel all on my own. So, that's something else I'm proud of. Like, I did it all by myself. Because as I got older, I just started realizing and learning so much about myself. I just started realizing, who cares if you teach me differently? Who cares? I am me, and that's all I can, you know, I can't help it. It's just I'm me, and I won't change for anybody because of who I am. And that's just how I've been ever since I got older, because I used to be so extremely shy because of my speech. I didn't really have any friends at all. I got made fun of a lot. And I came home crying pretty much every day after school until I got older. And then that's when I just ended up talking more, gaining more friends, because I was sick of it. I was sick of being stuck in myself. And I just had to get out of that. I just was too depressed on it because of people looking at me. But as I got older, I was like, the heck with this. I'm done being this way. I want friends. I had to have that confidence. I just couldn't be in my shell anymore. It was too hard. And so now that I'm older and not caring what I was thinking of me, I am so much happier. And I don't get me wrong, I still have my day. I still have my moments. I get frustrated. Right, with the online schooling right now, that's very frustrating. Trying to have a disability and him having, my son having a disability, my son having the same disability as well, and trying to help him with his homework, it's hard. It's been stressful. It's been frustrating. But we're all struggling with that. We're all struggling with homeschooling right now, online schooling. But I just wanted to hop on and talk again about me. I'm trying to find different stuff to talk about as well as the days go by, and I'll try to do another video tomorrow. Thank you.